Hello dear participants, welcome back to the final structural elucidation. This is somewhat little tougher molecule, therefore we shall see. This is the molecular weight of the compound. If you see, the molecular ion peak is very, very low, intense, and therefore it is shown here separately. If you see that, the molecular weight is look like at 207, and if you apply rule of 13, it may comes around C15 H15 plus 12, that is C15 and H27. If you see the nitrogen rule, there may be odd number of nitrogen present in the molecule, and the base peak is at 91. That means there is a possibility of tropelium ion, that is benzyl group is possible, that we can consider. There is no isotope. It may look like an isotope, but it is not isotope. Isotope will be minimum 2 different, M plus 2 peak, but this is M plus 1 peak. Therefore, this is not an isotopic peak. You should not confuse with that. It may look like a bromine, but it is not. If this peak is here, then we can consider it may be bromine, but it is not the isotopic peak. If you look at the IR spectra zone 1 is present, either it has to be amine or amide, NH. It is a typical NH stretching. Okay, it is not OH, it is actually NH stretching. And if you see, zone 2 is present, this is a 3000 mark. And both above 3000 and below 3000 are there, and therefore both sp3ch stretching is there and sp2ch stretching is there in the molecule. Okay, this is the, and therefore there is aliphatic part and aromatic part in the molecule. Since we have already seen a benzyl group in the mass spectra, and definitely there will be aromatic part, and there will be also aliphatic part. That's what the sp3ch stretching says. It may be also benzyl or other groups. The CH2 group in benzyl or other groups can give rise to this peak sp3ch. Okay, zone 3 is absent, but zone 4 is present. It is a typical carbonyl stretching, and therefore carbonyl is present. And if you see this, and there are benzyl group is there, amine is there, and carbonyl group is there. It may be amide or any other compound, or it may be any other compound, carbonyl compound. Okay, if you see the C13 NMR, there are around 10 peaks actually, but I restricted these peaks into one because all of them are aromatic protons. Actually there are 10 peaks, but together this is one batch. I consider this as one batch of peaks. If you consider this as one batch, that is aromatic carbons, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 type of carbon are there. And therefore, this must be somewhat a bigger molecule. We have to see that the peaks are to 120 to 120 ppm. This peak is aromatic carbon. And there is 172 peak around, which is due to carbonyl carbon, that we have already seen in IR, and that is confirmed again in C13 NMR. There are 4 deshielded carbon from 30 to 60. 30 to 60, there are deshielded carbon, therefore they must be connected to electronegative groups. And here also you can see one group which is highly deshielded. That we have to remember. Then if coming into proton NMR, here where we have to find the structure of the compound, let us analyze. You can see several peaks here, around 7 peaks are there. Let us analyze one by one. First peak, that is at 1.2 ppm, it is a triplet. You can see here it is a triplet, and since it is a triplet, it is 1.2 ppm. It is typical free proton, which is not attached to any electronegative groups. Okay, and therefore it is a triplet, therefore two hydrogen must be adjacent, and it integral value says it is three hydrogen, and therefore it must be 3CH3 and CH2. CH3 group that is splitted by CH2. Okay, then the second, let us see the second group. It is at 1.9 ppm. It may be connected to carbonyl group, or it may be any other group, or it may be a amine group, NH. It must be connected to carbonyl group or electronegative. It is a little deshielded, and since it is one, you can see it may be a CH that is connected to carbonyl, or it may be NH. That we have to confirm in later stages, because we have already seen NH stitching. There is no other possibility here, and therefore we consider this must be an NH group. There is no other singlet. Here there is a CH2 that we will see. NH is the signal at B, and if you see the peak at 2.5 ppm, which is connected to an electronegative group. Electronegative group has to be connected. It may be nitrogen, oxygen, in the marine club. It may be like that, connected to English, and it is a triplet. Since it is a triplet, there must be two adjacent nitrogens, and integral value says two, this signal, and therefore there must be CH2 fragment, and you cannot compare with this CH2. The C cannot be this CH2 because it is connected to CH3, then it should be quartet. But here it is a triplet, and therefore these two fragments are not same. These two fragments are different. That's what we have to confirm. Then there is a peak at 2.9 ppm. This is also highly deshielded, and therefore it must be also connected to an electronegative group. It may be carbonyl, may be nitrogen, it may be oxygen, like that. It has to be connected to that. If it is carbonyl, it will be around 2.2 2.5. since the value increases, it may not be exactly the carbonyl carbon, it may be nitrogen, or it may be directly oxygen, that we have to see. And therefore the possibility is CH2 and CH2, and therefore it is a triplet and two hydrogen, and these two match exactly each other, and therefore we can consider this CH2 as the D. And therefore, I take the same fragment here, CH2C and the CH2D, these two fragments. Okay, let us continue to evaluate other peaks. If you consider the signal at E, this signal, two hydrogen, which is at 3.8 ppm around, connected to, it is more electronegative group. It must be connected to either oxygen or something like that. It has to be directly connected to that. And it is a singlet, and therefore it must be a CH2 group, which is connected in both sides, either sides has to be connected by other carbons or nitrogen or oxygen which do not have a hydrogen. That is the case here. And if you see the signal F, which is a quartet, and therefore since it is a quartet, there must be a CH3 group which splits, and therefore I take from CH3, that is this signal, and therefore this signal CH3 and this signal are connected. These two are connected, and therefore this signal is splitted by this proton, and this proton is splitted by this proton. This is how we have to think, and therefore it is a signal of CH2 proton, that is denoted as F, but it is splitted by CH3A, because there is no other CH3 here. Only CH3 possible is there, and since it is a quartet, only CH3, and therefore I connect there. Okay, then if you see the one more spectrum at 5 hydrogen, one more signal at 7.2 ppm, which look like a aromatic system. An aromatic system which is mono substituted because it has 5 hydrogen. Okay, this is, let us combine all the fragments together. If you combine all the fragments together, we have identified NH group, we have identified CH3, CH2 group, and CH2 group, CO group, and CH2 CH2 group, and C6H5 CH2. This may be connected together. We have found all these groups. If you calculate the formula for these fragments totally together, it comes around this. And if you calculate the formula weight, it comes around 101. But the actual formula weight is 207. If you subtract 207 from 181, there is this one more 16 is remaining, and it is one more oxygen is possible, because if you see the chemical shift value of CH2F, it is around 3.8. There itself I told that it may be connected to a highly electronegative group directly, and this is the reason it is connected to O. But why I am not connecting this oxygen to any other group? Because in this fragment, this chemical shift value, based on the chemical shift value, I am connecting this oxygen to this CH2, not this to CH2. Okay. Right. Now, the molecular formula is okay, and therefore, if you connect using chemical shift formula, that means this O, it is connected to, it has to be connected to a carbonyl group. Therefore, the CH2 and CH3 fragment is there, O fragment, and it is connected to carbonyl. And there is a CH2 fragment, which has, and this CH2 is 2.5, and this CH2 is 2.9, because it is connected to nitrogen. That also I said, it has to be directly connected to nitrogen. And here also, this CH2 has a higher values. And therefore, there are three CH2 which has three carbon, yeah. And these carbons have higher values, and you can see here 3CH2 which has higher values. And there is 1CH2 which is very high. This is 3.8, and that is due to this proton. And that is due to this. You can see here CH2 which is connected to benzyl one side, the benzene ring one side, and nitrogen group another side, and there is no coupling. NH hydrogen will not couple. Here also there is no neighboring proton, and therefore this is a singlet, and which has around 3.8, and this is around this CH2 has triplet, okay, and that is around 2.5 or something. And this CH2 which is at 4.2, this CH2 is at 4.2, okay. And this is the structure of the compound that you have to connect. We have found some fragments, but you have to connect it to a particular fragment based on the chemical shift value. You have to give as a justification for chemical shift value, then you can able to join the fragments together clearly. I think thank you very much. Thank you. We will hereafter I will give, since I have elucidated many kinds of structure, there are some tough molecules are there. I give all the molecules to you as an assignment. Try to solve all the molecules. Later, I may give the answer for all of them. Thank you. With this, we wind up the structural elucidation for temporarily for now. You answer all the quiz. All the molecules you try, because we have tried, I have tried about 11 molecules, you have tried about 10 molecules, there are around 21 molecules we have already done. Then you must have already well versed to some extent in structural elucidation. Kindly try all the other molecules that I am going to give, around 30 molecules I am going to give you. Just try all the molecules. I will give the answers to all of them later, after you try. Okay. One more video I will make on 2D NMR. 2D NMR on proton 2D NMR and C13 and depth spectrum. We will deal with them in the next class. With that, we wind up all the classes in the workshop. And then on Monday, and not Monday, on Sunday evening, as we have already told, 5 to 6 we will have a final examination which includes everything from the beginning. Kindly watch all the videos and kindly go through all the structural elucidation and finally the 2D NMR. The final examination consists of all these things. Kindly get prepared and do well in the examination. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.